Disney Girl here, and today I'm going to be giving you guys all of the information that you will need to know about Disney's Magic Kingdoms game upcoming update. So we do have a lot of news that we need to talk about, some big changes once again with the kingdom, and also actually our community a little bit. We are getting a brand new community manager, which means we do need to say thank you and goodbye to Mark Andre, who has been our community manager for Game Loft's Disney Magic Kingdoms game now, I do believe, for the last couple of years. He's been my community manager, at least, for the game since I have started to play, so I have become very familiar with him, watching, obviously, him on the Facebook live streams and everything, but he is moving on to another project, and we are getting a new girl that is going to be replacing her, and say hello, guys, to Natalie. She did an amazing job on the Facebook live stream today. I just love the way she presented all the attractions and the costumes and the characters and everything. She really did an amazing job. So welcome, Natalie, and au revoir, Marc Andre. And again, thank you for all of your hard work with the community. And we do hope, Natalie, that you are just as involved with all of us as Marc Andre was in the past. All right, guys, let's talk about the new update. The new update is going to be Frozen 2 based. We are not going to be getting any additional permanent content to the kingdom, which means, guys, I know we've been talking about Lady and the Tramp as permanent content. We've been predicting that now for a bit, especially with Disney Plus now sort of coming into the picture and everything. We did think that they were going to be celebrating, you know, Disney Plus is like, you know, big sort of release and everything. They have decided to pass by that, and they have dove straight into a brand new style of event. So Frozen 2 is going to be the main focus of this update. So Frozen 2, what does that mean for the kingdom? What does it mean in terms of an event style change? So I'm going to be explaining all of that to you here right now. It is new to me, so some of the stuff I'm going to be talking about, and I'll let you know when I am, is all just sort of based off of my own theories of how they could possibly run an event like this. I don't think there's many sort of options. I think it's going to be pretty clear cut. It's going to be pretty straightforward in a lot of ways. I think that this is going to be a great way in the future to incorporate some other collections and stuff that do need larger expansions. So I will be talking to you guys about the different styles of events as well that DMK actually presents to us currently and how this sort of affects us going forward. So first and foremost, you guys probably know a lot about limited time events since we just finished up the Coco limited time event there. You guys know it's about 26 days. We get 7 new characters, usually 3 to 4 new attractions. We get some concessions, decorations usually, costumes even, not all the time, but we do get costumes. So you guys pretty much know how that works. It's pretty intense for 26 days. Now, you know, that's just for adding new collections to the kingdom. So for example, we had nothing to do with Coco. Coco was added. You know, we had in September, we had Finding Nemo. So Finding Nemo was added to the kingdom because we did not have that collection. So again, another 26 roughly day event. And again, we have to collect all of those new characters and attractions and all of that. Find a spot in our kingdom to put it, which by the way, is becoming increasingly difficult. So Natalie, if you are listening out there, or anybody that knows Natalie or wants to tell her, please give us some land. We are going to have a lot of problems with the stuff I'm about to show you today. So that is basically a limited time event. This update will not be a limited time event, okay? So when I say limited time event, that is the 26 days one, okay, with new collection. Now, we have had tower challenges in the past. I don't believe those are going anywhere. We are still getting those. Those are usually used to add anywhere between 1 and 3 characters into the kingdom, okay? Now, we've only had a couple of events really that we've managed to get more than one new character that's been added to collections. Tower challenges started off as just one character that we worked towards the entire way. Then they started adding, you know, once they started realizing, oh, we need to add other characters with that collection too, they started adding one premium and then obviously one featured, which is the featured ones what you work towards collecting for the entire tower challenge. Now, Over the summer, they tested out having three. So for The Lion King, they had three new characters come into the kingdom, Shanzi, Bonzai, and Ed. So the three hyenas in The Lion King. It was amazing, but it was very challenging to get all three of those plus everything else you needed or wanted to collect if you guys were newer kingdomers. So three, I think, was a little bit much. I think they tested that out. They realized it was too much. They needed to kind of scale back a little bit, which is why I do think this style is now happening. Now, tower challenges, guys, if you guys are new to the game, or even if you're vets, it's still important to know, tower challenges are 15 days. There are three chapters to a tower challenge. Maleficent comes, she has an evil tower in the kingdom, and she curses, you know, attractions and whatnot, and we have to collect currency, try and get a featured character, all that kind of stuff. 15 days, though. Three chapters. Each chapter is 5 days long. So, that being said, this event here should be a little bit longer than a tower challenge, but shorter than a limited time event. So 26 days versus 15, I'm guessing it's going to be somewhere in the middle of that, all right? So this is what we're talking about now for what is going to be called a mini event. Now, they haven't given it an official name. They just said like a little, like tiny or smaller event. They didn't give it a specific name. I have given it the smaller name already, like for ages now. Before tower challenges were even a thing, I thought, you know, like a mini event, right? Which essentially tower challenge was almost that, but not quite what I was thinking. So I feel like this mini event is literally gonna be what I had visualized happening before tower challenges were around. So the mini event is going to give us an opportunity, guys, to collect old characters through an event storyline, which is going to be really, really interesting. So we're going to be able to collect characters without spending our gems or real money on legendary chests. So as you guys know, if you've missed an event, you guys can get all these characters via tower challenge or legendary chests. Now, tower challenges have limited you, like what you could really collect from these collections. So I think this is gonna really open the door to sort of collecting some of those more challenging characters to get from those legendary chests. It's gonna be a little bit easier maybe now to actually collect those. And it is a little bit more friendly, I would say, for players, whether you're new or old. It just gives you a really great opportunity to sort of expand your kingdom and everything. Now, just so you guys know, this update thing here, we don't have an exact amount of days or anything. They were pretty tight-lipped about everything in terms of the characters' names and everything. I can give you those names, though, today. Yes, you may go, oh no, it's a Frozen 2 spoiler. You know what? It's not really. I'm just like, I mean, they're character names. We already know the salamander is Bruni, right? Nobody's really like, maybe, how do I want to put this? I think even Disney has said Bruni, but I think they've been like kind of trying to avoid using it. But I know that if you buy the plushy salamander at the Disney store, it will say Bruni on it. So, I mean, you do know. There's been leaks online about it already. That's actually like a real thing. But however, there are two characters that are going to be incorporated into the kingdom with this Frozen 2 mini event that haven't been given names, or at least if they have, it's been a little bit more tight-lipped. So I'm gonna kind of tell you a little bit about those characters. I don't really know what their roles are specifically in the film, but I do have a general idea like who they are or what they represent. So I'm gonna be able to fill you guys in on that, so we're not so blindsided as like, why did we get these two? Because in the trailers we've been seeing kind of other characters that we thought maybe would have been coming, and these two were a little bit of a surprise, at least for me. So I'll get into that in just a couple of minutes here. I will address the attractions and stuff like that first. So the first thing, though, that you guys will need to mark in your calendars right now, the first date is Tuesday, November the 19th, okay? November the 19th, we have an update. That is when the update goes live. All platforms should be getting it on the same day. I know we've all had problems the last little while getting certain updates. Last time it was the iOS users, so that was me. Like, they basically had to take the game off the App Store. It was a nightmare. Before that, I believe it was Android that had a big issue. And then before that, I believe it was PC. And there was another platform as well that really struggled. But anyways, you guys know we've been going through a lot with them in terms of, you know, them being able to put out a game that works right away with the update. So Obviously, things like that happen. We just had a lot of it lately, but you know what? We're working around it. We're a community. We're sticking together with this game, right? So Tuesday, November 19th, the update goes live. Make sure you guys refresh your app store on the 19th at around 11 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. That should be when you get your calendar, and that's usually when you will also be able to update your game. You might be able to do it a little bit before or a little bit later on, but we all should be getting the update on the 19th. So hopefully everything runs smoothly for Natalie now that Marc-Andre is officially gone from Gameloft and DMK. Well, I think he's still being a part of Gameloft, just a different game. They just didn't say which one yet. So anyway, doesn't really matter. Tuesday, November 19th, update, okay? The event for Frozen 2, guys. This is the second date you need to put into your calendars right now. November the 26th. So 1 week after the update goes live, we have the event starting. So as we know, Frozen 2, sorry guys, I'm having like trouble breathing or whatever. I have no idea what's going on right now. I'm like talking too much and not taking enough breaths. I need to like, I'm just so excited about this update. So if I sound like I run out of breath, I'm literally running out of breath because I'm so excited. And I just want to get all this info out to you like super quick. Okay, whew. I work out. Yeah, all right. Anyways, keep going here. November 26th, 1 week later from when the update goes live, the event will be starting. So as you guys know, Frozen 2 is released, the film, in theaters on the 22nd. So this is going to be a couple of days after the movie comes out. We will get the start of the event. So a lot of us will already know what these characters represent anyways before the event happens. So, I mean, it's like spoilers, but not really spoilers, right? I mean, I think we have a general idea of what's going on here in Frozen 2. Trailers have been just been leaking more and more information the last, like, couple of days. It's been insane. Like, I've seen a scene now where Kristoff actually tries to propose to Anna, okay? But we do have to actually wait for all of that information. So, we do see him at least making an attempt. He's got a ring, guys. It's gonna happen by the end of the movie. Like, we don't know for sure, but there's just no way that he's got a ring and he's not gonna make it happen by the end of the film. Face facts, guys. So it is pretty awesome that we are gonna be able to see that whole process happen. I was getting worried we weren't gonna be able to, but I'm super duper happy, because at least if Elsa didn't get a love interest, which we don't really know that for sure yet, but at least Anna will be getting her happily ever after, that is for sure. So again, November 19th, the update goes live, the 26th, we actually start the mini event. So this is obviously gonna take us into December and it's gonna be really awesome. Now, for those of you guys that are newer Kingdomers, this is gonna be very intense. You will have a lot of stuff to do, all right? You'll be collecting not only new characters that are going to be added to the game, you're going to also be collecting old characters. So this is where things will get interesting. Anna and Elsa will be available through the event quest storyline, okay? So that means just like a limited time event, right, the 26-day one, you guys will be getting the opportunity to collect those two characters. And face it, guys, they're pretty awesome if you can get those ones. And that's even if that's all you do, you will have the opportunity to collect those two characters in this mini event. And guys, guess what? It's gonna be free. There's no gems, no real money to this. All you have to do is play the game, and I'm gonna give you guys all the tutorial on how to do that, so don't even worry. We do have to wait though until we get an idea from the update when it goes live for all that additional information, but I'll keep you guys posted on that, of course. So that leaves us though to one premium character that will be available in a bundle, and that is Olaf. So if we're putting out real money this time, guys, it's gonna be for Olaf. We're probably looking at the bundle adding some like character tokens with it. We're not getting any concessions or decorations in this update, so that does mean a few things. That means that they can't do too much with this bundle except give us character tokens to maybe get them to a 2 or a 3 or something like that. But it doesn't really matter. We're getting Olaf in a premium bundle. If you guys don't have him, this will be the time to add him. He should be, in my currency, like anywhere between $6.99 and $13.99. But again, depending on where you are in the world, that will depend. So I know the States and the US, it's probably gonna be about $6.99 for that premium character. So if you guys save up like $10, you should be okay. Now again, it could be more than that, but they didn't say. So since this is a new thing with the kingdom, we'll kind of have to wait and see. But that seems to typically be the style of bundle and stuff like that in tower challenges and limited time events. So I think that gives us a pretty good idea anyways of how much these things are going to cost. Okay, so now that kind of takes us to we'll talk about the newer characters in a second, though, but at least that will take us through the storyline, right? We'll be able to add those characters. If you are a bigger kingdom, so if you're like me and you guys already have Anna, Elsa, Kristoff, Sven, Hans, all of them, right? If you have all the Frozen collection already, maybe you have some of them maxed out. I don't have all of them maxed out, but I have a couple of them maxed out. What that will mean is that it'll be a little bit easier for us to finish the mini event, or at least we'll be a little bit more ahead. So basically they didn't say, if you're a small kingdom, you won't be able to finish this. It just means you're gonna have to put in a little bit more work. So for me, this is gonna be a little bit easier, which is gonna be really nice for me. It might kind of give me a little bit to, you know, work on some of the other collections and all that kind of stuff, work on leveling up some of these characters at the same time. Cause you may not be able to do that, right? Like earlier on, just for conflict drops and stuff like that with the tokens. So it'll just sort of depend, but I think this will give me an opportunity to do some additional stuff with the kingdom. Like, for example, redecorate it, because we don't have enough land yet in our kingdom to actually put out all of the great new attractions, which you see before you. I am going to be talking about each one specifically now. Then we'll get into some of the costumes and stuff like that, and those new characters, and who they are. Yeah, so we're getting some name reveals today for those characters. So let's talk about the first attraction here. So this one is pretty amazing. I love it. This is called the Stone Giant Waterfall. We have seen this one actually, well, maybe not the attraction itself, but we have seen a scene in Frozen 2's trailers that actually looks exactly like this. This is actually the one, guys, if you guys remember, you'll see Anna and Olaf in like an ice boat together. If you guys remember that particular scene, this is what it's supposed to represent here. We've got some great fall colors. We've got the rock giant. And guys, if you guys pay really close attention, you can see him moving. You can see it in the trailer as well, but you can actually see this attraction moving, which makes it pretty incredible. So I am really excited to see if there are any additional animations here. Maybe this will be a happiness sort of attraction for some of our little visitors that come. It'll just sort of depend. We don't know a lot about it, but I'm assuming it's some sort of attraction ride here. We should have some sort of animation with that. It is pretty amazing. All right, let's talk about the next one here. This one is very colorful. I love this one. It's super cool, beautiful, very colorful. We are going to be getting apparently a lot of animations with our characters on this attraction. At least that was the general idea that we were getting from them today. They didn't say much, but that was the general idea. This one is actually the Enchanted Forest, guys. So you can imagine, I'm pretty sure Bruni might even be making an appearance here. It's going to be really awesome to actually be able to see all of that, obviously. But yeah, we kind of have to wait a little bit longer to find out all the animations and stuff like that, because they did not reveal that to us today. Now, the final attraction here is called... All right, you guys ready for it? And pay close attention, because I didn't notice this like right away during the live streaming. But this one is called the Water Spirit Wave Ride, okay? And look, the Water Spirit... is that horse, remember, that we saw in the in Frozen 2 trailer? Yeah, that's the water horse. Pretty cool, right? The animation is just incredible on this. This is probably, guys, my favorite. I mean, I'm gonna wait to see it in my own kingdom and stuff like that, but I think this is gonna look amazing in and around my Frozen section. It's gonna be super incredible. Like, I literally just cannot wait for this one. I don't know how we're getting three attractions though in our kingdom right now. We have no room to put them. This is a problem, okay? Face facts, guys, we have a huge problem with land. I'm gonna have to like empty out an entire section, and that's why I'm saying, like, even if the event is supposed to be a little easier for bigger kingdoms and stuff like that, that would only be because we actually have more work to do, because we have to find spots in our kingdom that we gotta clear out. Right? Like, we have to decide what collections are we kind of done with and can put away. So, like, I mean, right now I'm like going, okay, I need to max out a couple of collections, put away the stuff. I hate putting away my attractions. Guys, it drives me crazy when I make my kingdom look beautiful and then I have to ruin it. Like, that drives me bonkers, especially with this new thrill zone and stuff like that. Like, I know it's not in every section of the kingdom, but it drives me bonkers that, like, you have to miss out on that while you redesign your kingdom, right? So, just because you guys think, oh, well, it's just one area of the kingdom, there's a whole bunch of other areas you could do. It's like, yeah, but it kind of depends on where the attractions fit properly, right? They don't really show you the best spot for them. They just kind of usually put them wherever they feel like, or, you know, they clear a section out and put it here. So they put it at the front of the kingdom because they need all that space. Look at how big these attractions are. It is wild. I don't know what I'm going to do, but yeah, I'll fill you guys in. I need to kind of sleep on it, maybe come up with some strategies here, decide what collections I can put in storage for now. But yeah, anyways, these attractions are amazing, but we just need more land for it. So hint, hint, DMK. Please, new land soon. I know you keep saying it's coming soon, but you've been saying it's coming soon for months and months and months, and I really just need land. Okay, now let's move off the whole land topic. We've discussed the three new attractions that are going to be part of the mini event. It will be progress, guys, so it'll be like, you know, you welcome a character, you get an attraction. You welcome a character, you get an attraction. So it's just going to kind of work like that, right? Kind of typical, similar to a limited time event. All right, now let's kind of dive in here to the characters. We already talked about Anna, Elsa, and Olaf on how to get them. The next three characters, again, this is where the name reveals are going to be coming out right now, and I'm going to be giving you a little, I guess, description or backstory, I guess, to these characters so you actually know who they are. Because, you know, there's nothing overly exciting about their costumes. It's just, they're cool, but, I mean, we know nothing about these people. Like, who are they? So I'm going to tell you guys right now. There's a little guy that you can barely see in the corner there. That little tiny salamander, that is Bruni, guys. That name, I think a lot of us already know who that is, but if you don't, that is Bruni. I'll talk to you guys a little bit about him as well. But the big thing is these other two characters. You ready? The girl that is in the middle there, her name is Honey Marin. And the boy, his name is Ryder. Kind of like Flynn Ryder, right? Just a little bit. Doesn't that remind you of it? Anyway, so Honey Marin and Ryder. All right, you guys ready to find out more about these characters? So these two, if you guys are wondering, they are brother and sister. All right. Ryder is very high energy. He's a playful guy. He seems to laugh a lot, but he has a huge connection, a very deep connection with reindeer. Does that sound familiar to anyone? Yes, Kristoff, guys. I think there's going to be a huge thing here between Sven, Kristoff, and Ryder. I think it's going to be amazing. I know there is a scene in the movie, actually. I haven't seen the movie, guys, but the trailer. The trailer, we do see a scene where Kristoff is riding Sven, and there's a whole bunch of other reindeer sort of running with him. So the whole thing behind that is apparently Ryder and Kristoff are working together to save all these reindeer. Now, from what, that is to be determined. But anyways, they kind of become really good friends, and I think it's great that, you know, Kristoff is gonna get like a guy pal, you know, like a buddy. It's gonna be really, really nice to see. Okay, so here's a little bit more about Honey Marin. So Honey Marin is actually going to be closer with Elsa. So Kristoff and Ryder are gonna be closer, and Honey Marin and Elsa are going to be closer because Honey Marin is going to help guide Elsa to understand a lot about some of the things, like the symbols we've seen, for example, in the trailer, like all those diamonds, what they mean. Honey Marin is going to be helping Elsa sort of through that journey and sort of through understanding the Enchanted Forest and, you know, what everything sort of means. So Honey Marin is going to be a huge influence here to Elsa. I'm not saying there's a love interest or anything here, but I think it could bring a nice, like, strong friendship connection, very similar to what Ryder is going to be doing for Kristoff. So I am really interested to see sort of how all of that sort of comes into play, but it gives you guys a general idea. You know, we've got, you know, Honey Marin, who's very strong leader, you know, very out there. She's very helpful. And then we've got Ryder, who's a little bit, again, more like Kristoff, a little bit more laid back, but has, like, you know, real love for animals and especially reindeer. So it is going to be pretty amazing to have Honey Marin and Ryder in the kingdom. So let me know in the comment section below if you are excited to have these two characters in the kingdom. And I think that gives you guys a little bit to think about in terms of the direction of the storyline for this mini event. I keep wanting to say Tower Challenge or limited time event, but it's a mini event, guys. Face it, mini event. So now I'll talk to you guys a little bit about Bruni. Bruni, some of you guys may know quite a bit about him, but some of you may not, all right? So Bruni, what do we know about him? He is a salamander, okay? And you may think, oh, so he's just a salamander who happens to be really good friends with Elsa and love her snowflakes. No, he's a little bit more than that, actually. He is a fire spirit. I don't know if we're gonna see Bruni being responsible for all those pink and kind of purpley, whatever sort of flames that we saw in the Enchanted Forest and stuff like that. I'm not sure if it's Bruni's fault for all of it, but he is a representative, I guess, of fire. So we'll see sort of how that all pans out. Now, we didn't get, obviously, Anna and Elsa's parents, so Queen Iduna and King Agnar. We aren't getting anything with them, but we will see them in the film as children, which is going to be really neat. And we'll find out a little bit more history, I think, about the two of them and, you know, where they came from. So I think that's going to be really unique when we do see it. But for now, guys, that is really all the information I have on these characters. I mean, I do have a little bit more, but I think it's kind of like irrelevant at this point. But you guys get a general idea, I think, now about those three new characters. So we have Bruni, Ryder and Honey Marin that are going to be added here to the kingdom. Now, besides characters, we are also going to be getting some costumes. Let's dive into the really good stuff, okay? So, I'm surprised maybe on the name of this costume, but it's fine. The first one is going to be for Elsa, the travel costume. Again, I'm like the travel costume, but whatever, it's fine. So you guys can see here on the screen, this is Elsa in this costume. These are going to be the requirements for it. So as you can see Elsa's tiara is there as well. That is used to level her up too. So we will be collecting more of this character token and stuff like that. So if you guys have already maxed out Elsa, you guys will need to collect this token once again for her. Now there are some fabrics as well. This is not a comfy costume, so it's not comfy fabric, but it's like travel fabric, I'm gonna call it, okay? So we're gonna need to collect 12 of those. My guess is it's probably, depending on which one we get first, whether it's gonna be Anna or Elsa's in terms of the storyline and stuff that they're gonna give us for this mini event, I think we're probably looking at anywhere between rare and epic maybe for this fabric. Will be interesting. So my guess is the snowflake token at the top, which we need 30 of, which is actually a lot. We'll be able to collect that from characters doing in 1 hour quests. So we need 30 of those. Those will be common drops, which is gonna be great. Elsa's tiara, I think that was rare, but I haven't collected it in a long time. So if you guys do know, you can put it in the comment section for all of us. And then again, the fabric there. So that might be why it would be epic. We will need 11,000 magic, guys. So if you guys have lots of magic, that's fine. But be aware, you will need to save up some magic if you are a smaller kingdom for that. So start saving up, you know, do what you need to do, but you know, make sure you've probably got about like 30 to 50,000 when the event starts, okay? Because you will need that magic to welcome these characters and stuff like that and costumes. So now we'll go into the time for this. 6 hours. Like that's a really long time to bring in a costume in my opinion. This should be 60 minutes, but 6 hours. Wow. Like this event better be long because that's gonna be brutal, I think. But anyways, travel costume is there for Elsa. We are not getting a comfy costume at this time. The next one is for Anna. This is called the travel costume as well. So this one here, as you guys can see, I think this one will be first. So I think Anna is going to be the first one that we can welcome into the kingdom through the sort of the event quest storyline and everything. But I think after that, we'll be able to start collecting for her costume. I think Elsa will be last with her costume, but that's my opinion. I figure we'll start the dialogue and stuff for this mini event with Anna. So we're gonna need 10 snowflakes. Again, those common snowflakes. We're gonna need a character token that I believe, I guess it's specific to her. I haven't collected it in a long time. But yeah, that's one of her character tokens there. And then again, that travel fabric. Now, this is a bit weird. This is actual currency, okay? So this is where I'm saying, like, save up magic for this event, but you'll also need to save up currency when it becomes available. Now, this is going to be, I'm going to call it mini event currency or just event currency, guys. So it means the same thing. So the 500 currency there, guys, I feel like is pretty reasonable. It's good. The one thing, though, is it is 60 minutes to bring in, which is fair as well. But again, I think we're probably going to be looking at some trouble maybe with the fabric collecting that. Maybe it'll be uncommon, but maybe it even could be rare. It just depends on the direction the kingdom goes with this. But yeah, it will be interesting to see. But just so you guys know, there is a difference between bringing in Elsa's travel costume and Anna's. So just be aware of that, guys. You will need magic for some things in this event and event currency for other things in this event. All right, we don't know cost of the attractions or anything else just yet, but at least we have an idea here of the costumes and what we're looking at for the event. So that really leaves it, guys, as three new attractions for a mini event and three new characters plus two costumes. So it's gonna be really, really amazing, and I'm really, really excited for the very first mini event with the kingdom. So this is the first time ever they're doing this for a very, very important movie. So I really hope most of this runs smoothly for the community. So again, make sure that you guys download the update on the 19th. And of course, start the event with all of us on the 26th. I'll obviously be doing videos. Maybe I'll be able to stream by then, probably not, but I'll obviously be doing maybe some Instagram streams and stuff like that for you guys. I might be doing quite a few of those. So if you guys don't follow me on Instagram, you guys can head over there as well. Follow along. I will be going live having discussions with you guys. The only thing is I can't show you my gameplay, but I can through my videos here on YouTube. Until I can get back streaming again, unfortunately, this is sort of how we have to do it. Still need my designed special live streaming setup, but it will be coming in the future. I'm still trying to give you guys updates every video about all of that. The progress is kind of the same at the moment, but yeah, I'll kind of keep you guys posted on everything. So hopefully you guys have enjoyed this video. If you guys did, make sure you guys give it a big Mickey thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel if you guys are new, and of course, hit that bell for post notifications. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys for the next DMK video. Bye!